بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح للأمة فكشف الله به الأمة وجاهد في سبيل ربه حتى أتاه اليقين فاللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين ثم أما بعد فيا عباد الله أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله عز وجل قال عز من قائل يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, we are all aware that every Muslim must perform the obligatory different kinds of worships like Salah, Zakah, Siyam, Hajj, etc. And Alhamdulillah, by the grace of Allah, last khutbah I shed some light on the importance of performing the obligatory prayers and having khushu' in them. Yet, Islam and being obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and being righteous slave for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not only to perform the obligatory worships. Islam is also to do good to people and to have good morals. In the Holy Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala connects between the command to worship Him alone and the command to do good to people. So we read in the Holy Quran, وَاعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا وَبِذِي الْقُرْبَى وَالْيَتَامَى وَالْمَسَاكِينِ وَالْجَارِ ذِي الْقُرْبَى وَالْجَارِ الْجُنُبِ وَالصَّاحِبِ بِالْجَنْبِ وَابْنِ السَّبِيلِ وَمَا مَلَكَتْ أَيْمَانُكُمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ مَنْ كَانَ مُخْتَالًا فَخُورًا. And worship Allah and do not associate any partner with Him, and do good to parents, relatives, orphans, the needy, the near neighbor, the neighbor farther away, the companion at your side, the wayfarer, etc., etc., meaning, and do good to all people. So both the two sides should always and must always go together, that we have a good relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in our hearts and through the performance of the worships which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made obligatory on us, and along with this we have also to have good relationship with people and to do good to people and not to harm any one of them, and this is also an Islamic obligation. And actually, the worships themselves are meant for improving our characters and our morals. One of the main aims of all the worships in Islam is to improve and promote our good morals. So regarding the Salah, we read in the Holy Quran, إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ تَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ. Indeed, prayers forbid or prohibit immorality and wrongdoing. If one performs the prayer in the manner that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with and the manner that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has taught to us, then his character will be an excellent one and he will always be doing good to all people. Regarding the zakah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, خُذْ مِنْ أَمْوَالِهِمْ صَدَقَةً تُطَهِّرُهُمْ وَتُزَكِّيهِمْ بِهَا. Take from their wealth a charity that you purify them and sanctify them with. And regarding sawm, fasting, you all know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not accept the siyam of that person who does not abandon false speech and acting upon it. And in Hajj, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not only forbid disobeying Him, but He also forbids disputing with people during Hajj, which is a bad moral. فَلَا رَفَسَ وَلَا فُسُوقَ وَلَا جِدَالَ في الحج. And actually, different good morals are different parts of faith. And that's why, for example, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَالْحَيَاءُ شُعْبَةٌ مِنَ الْإِيمَانِ. And modesty is one branch of faith. The relationship between faith and good morals is very clear in the hadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So in one hadith, he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, مَنْ كَانَ يُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ فَلْيَقُلْ خَيْرًا أَوْ لِيَصْمُتْ وَمَنْ كَانَ يُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ فَلْيُكْرِمْ جَارَهُ وَمَنْ كَانَ يُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ فَلْيُكْرِمْ ضَيْفَهُ. Whosoever believes in Allah and in the last day, he should either speak nicely or just keep silent. And whosoever believes in Allah and the last day, he should show hospitality to his neighbor. And whosoever believes in Allah and the last day, he should show hospitality to his guests. And in another hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى يحب لأخيه ما يحب لنفسه. No one of you will attain the perfect form of Iman until he loves for all other people whatever he likes, the same that he loves for himself. Actually, good morals are the fruit of the perfect Islam and the perfect Iman. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was once asked, O Messenger of Allah, Ayyul Islami Khayr, which are the best characteristics of Islam? The Prophet's answer was, أن تطعم الطعام وتقرأ السلام على من عرفت ومن لم تعرف. It's to feed people food and to greet people with the greetings of peace, whether you know them or those you, whom that you don't know. Also give them the greetings of peace. And this is, you know, the good moral that the true Islam and true Iman call us all for. And actually, the opposite is also true, that bad morals violate one's perfect Iman. And that's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَيْسَ الْمُؤْمِنُ بِالطَّعَانِ وَلَا اللَّعَانِ وَلَا الْفَاحِشِ وَلَا الْبَذِيءِ. A true believer is not that one who slanders, abuses, or who uses offensive language and bad and obscene language. This one cannot be a perfect believer and cannot be a true believer. The rewards that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prepared for people of good morals are so great. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, مَا مِنْ شَيْءٍ أَثْقَلُ فِي مِيزَانِ الْعَبْدِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ مِنْ حُسْنِ الْخُلُقِ. Nothing is heavier in the scale of the good deeds of the slave of Allah on the day of judgment than good morals. The person attains in paradise a higher degree according to his good morals. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, the believer with the most perfect Iman is the believer with the most perfect morals. And he also said that a servant of Allah will attain by his good morals a degree in paradise which is for those who fast during the daytime and who offer voluntary salah prayers during the night. So people who fast during the daytime and make tahajjud and qiyam al-layl during the night, they are given a high degree in paradise. And the person with good morals will attain the same high degree by his good morals and by having always a good attitude towards people and being nice to them and being kind to them and doing his best not to harm them of anything, even by a little word. More than that, those people of good morals will be very near to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in paradise. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ مِنْ أَحَبِّكُمْ إِلَيَّ وَأَقْرَبِكُمْ مِنِّي مَجْلِسًا يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَحَاسِنَكُمْ أَخْلَاقًا. The dearest amongst you to me and the closest to me in paradise will be those of the best manners and behaviors amongst you. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us all the true understanding of Islam and the true application of Islam. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala improve our relationship with Him subhanahu wa ta'ala by having the due khushu' and worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more and more. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also improve our relationship with people, that we always do good to them and that we always have good relations with them. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله وكفى وصلاة وسلاما على عباده الذين اصطفى، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. وبعد. Acting badly or having bad morals and acting badly towards the others or harming them is severely punished by Islam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was once asked about a woman who offers the obligatory prayers, gives the zakah, fasts during the month of Ramadan, and does a lot of other good deeds, but she harms her neighbors. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told she will be in hellfire for that single reason, that she harms her neighbors. So we have to avoid harming others. And one form of harming others is to take unrightly something from their, you know, properties. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, those who acquire wrongfully the property of others will be cast in hellfire. Someone may think that he can escape the punishment in this world by, you know, getting some haram money or, you know, assaulting the rights of another. He thinks that he can escape the punishment in this world, and that's true. He may be able to escape the punishment in the world, but he will never be able to escape the punishment in the hereafter. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to his companions one day, إِنَّكُمْ تَخْتَصِمُونَ إِلَيْهِ وَلَعَلَّ بَعْضَكُمْ أَنْ يَكُونَ أَلْحَنَ بِحُجَّتِهِ مِنْ بَعْضٍ فَأَقْضِي لَهُ بِنَحْوِ مَا أَسْمَعُ فَمَنْ قَضَيْتُ لَهُ بِحَقِّ أَخِيهِ فَإِنَّمَا أَقْطَعُ لَهُ قِطْعَةً مِنَ النَّارِ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam once told his companions, you bring your disputes before me for judgment, and some of you may be more eloquent than others in plea, so I give judgment on their behalf according to what I hear from them. But whomever I give him the undue thing out of the right of his brother, he must not take it, for I am really giving him one portion from hellfire. Of course, also, we must not wrong people, and we have to avoid the dua of the wronged person that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, وَاتَّقُوا دَعْوَةَ الْمَظْلُومِ فَإِنَّهُ لَيْسَ بَيْنَهَا وَبَيْنَ اللَّهِ حِجَابٍ. And avoid the dua of the wronged person, that he makes dua against you when you wrong him. For there is no barrier between it and Allah. Allah is going to accept the dua of the mazloom, the wronged person. So you must not wrong anybody, otherwise the outcome, the consequence will be very bad in the hereafter and maybe in this world as well. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam once asked the companions, أَتَدْرُونَ مَنِ الْمُفْلِسِ فَأَجَابَ الصَّحَابَةِ الْمُفْلِسُ فِينَا مَنْ لَا دِرْهَمَ لَهُ وَلَا مَتَاعَ. فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, لا, ولكن المفلس من يأتي يوم القيامة بصلاة وزكاة وصيام, ويأتي وقد شتم هذا وقذف هذا وأكل مال هذا وسفك دم هذا وضرب هذا, فيأخذ هذا من حسناته وهذا من حسناته, فإن فنيت حسناته أخذ من خطاياهم فطرحت عليه ثم طرح في النار. The Prophet once asked the companion, do you know who's the bankrupt? They say, O Messenger of Allah, the bankrupt is that person who does not have any money and does not have any property. The Prophet ﷺ told them, no, this is not the bankrupt person that I meant. The bankrupt person is that one who will come on the day of judgment with lot of prayers, lot of zakah, lot of siyam that he has already offered in the world. But he has also slandered that person, abused that person, took money unduly out of the right of that person, shed the blood of that person. So all those people will take from his hasanat on the day of judgment. And if his hasanat finish before he can give them back their due rights, and that's on the day of judgment, then it will be taken from their sayyiat, from their bad deeds, and added to his record of deeds, and then he will be thrown into hellfire. This is the, you know, how dangerous is, you know, to wrong somebody or to harm him. So, inshallah, in this life, and life is very short, we have to do our best, you know, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the most proper way, which must lead us to have good relations with people as well, not to act unrightly and not to harm people of anything. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us all among us the pious believers who are given the best rewards in paradise. Ameen. We have also to make dua for our brothers in Afghanistan, as they had a very severe flood. And there are some victims there, so we have to make dua for and remember them all in our dua, inshaAllah. Allahumma ahdina fi man hadayt, wa afina fi man afayt, wa tawallana fi man tawallayt, wa barik Allahumma lana fi ma a'tayt, wa qina wasrif anna sharra ma qadayt, fa innaka subhanaka taqdi wa la yuqda alayk. اللهم نسألك الجنة وما قرب إليها من قول وعمل, ونعوذ بك من النار وما قرب إليها من قول وعمل. اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين, اللهم ارحم أمواتنا أجمعين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا, وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين, واجعلنا للمتقين إماما. وصل اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم, وأقم الصلاة.